means we have to follow any application, we must and should we follow the some standards, right? So there are standard bodies at the regional and country as well as international level. So based on the area of operations, the standards are maintained for the governments and professional institutes on industry circumstances. Okay, so in India there is a standard body under the government of India. Okay, there are standard and proprietary technologies, and the second one is the adoption of technology in USA and Europe. Okay, so these standards containing some technical specifications to be consistently used for the rules, guidelines and definitions of characteristics. It gives some rules and regulations for the standards. Okay, as part of this, the first standard is ETSI. ETSI full form means European Telecommunication Standard Institutes. Okay, it is an independent non-profit standardization institutes catering to telecommunications industry in the European but having a worldwide scope. So mobile computing is standardized under this ETSI. Prime objective is to support global harmonization by providing a forum in which all the key players can contribute actively. Means the Internet Engineering Task Force is the standard making body for the internet and related technologies. It is an open international community of network designers, operators and vendors and some research concerned people. Okay, and next standard is ISO. I think all of you well aware of this ISO standard. What the full form of ISO? International Organization for Standardization. Okay, so these mobile computing networks is also standardized in the part of ISO certification. Okay, ISO a full form is International Organization for Standardization. So this ISO is a worldwide federation of national standard bodies from more than 140 countries, one of each country. And this ISO is non-governmental organization established in the year of 1947. So the main aim of ISO is to promote the development of standardization and related activities in the world with a view of facilitating the development of standard activities. Okay, as part of this, and it also developed the corporation in the spheres of intellectual scenarios, technologies, scientific, intellectual, technological, and economic activities also. Okay, sometimes ISO makes its own standard or it adopts standard from its members' organization. Okay, in this ISO we have totally 7 layer model for open system intercommunication in ISO standard. And next is the OMA. OMA means the full form of OMA is Open Mobile Alliance. Open Mobile Alliance. The Open Mobile Alliance has been established by the consolidation of WAP Forum and the Open Mobile Architecture Innovative. It intends to expand the market for the entire industry by resolving barriers to interoperability and supporting a seamless and easy to use mobile experience from end users. Means it gives the Open Mobile Alliance encourages competition through an innovative and differentiation while ensuring the interoperability of your mobile services. So the supporters of Open Mobile Alliance recognizes the benefit, significant industry benefits of creating standards organization. Means that include all elements of the wireless value chain. Okay, and it gives the wireless and contribute to time and efficient introduction of services to the applications in the market sector. The WAP and MMS standards are created, maintained, and managed by the Open Mobile Alliance. And next one is also all of you well known about the standards, IEEE standards. Means the IEEE means Institute of Electrical and Electronics Engineers. What is the full form of IEEE? Institute of Electrical and Electronics Engineers. So this IEEE Standards Association is an organization that produces standards which are developed and used internationally. Okay, so suppose we are doing any paper presentation or we have done any project publications. Okay, all these are done in IEEE standards. Manamu chestu untam kada so many certifications. అవి ఏ స్టాండర్డ్ ఫాలో అవుతున్నామా, IEEE స్టాండర్డ్ IEEE లో పబ్లిష్ చేస్తున్నామా, దాన్ని బట్టి కూడా చూసుకుంటాం కదా. వైల్ దిస్ IEEE స్టాండర్డ్ ఫోకసెస్ కన్సిడరబుల్ రిసోర్సెస్ ఆన్ ద లాంగ్ రెస్పెక్టెడ్ ఫుల్ కాన్సిక్వెన్సెస్. ఓకే, that means it points newly and innovative programs to increase the value of IEEE standards of members in the industry and in the global society. Means this IEEE members continue to set the pace for the development of standard products in as part of in technical reports and documentation and ensure sound engineering practices in worldwide. Means this IEEE demonstrates strong support of an industry consequences process for the development of standards and operating procedures and guidelines. It sets some specific guidelines to the particular applications. And the next standard is EIA standard. Okay, this is the Electronics Industry Association standard. This is the Electronics Industry Association standard. That means it's a national trade organization within the US and includes the full spectrum of its electronics industry. Okay, the Alliance is a partnership of electronic and high-tech associations and companies whose mission is promoting the market development and competitiveness of the US high technology industry through domestic and international policy efforts. Okay, and this Electronic Industry Association is a national trade organization within us that includes the full spectrum of US electronic industries.
And this EIA is one of the most commonly used standard in the standard for the 25-pin connector between a computer and a modem. This partnership of electronic and high-tech associations and companies whose mission is promoting the market development and competitiveness of the US high technology industry. And the next standard is the ITU. This ITU standard is the full form of ITU is International Telecommunications Union. Okay, International Telecommunications Union. It was founded on the principle of cooperation between the governments and the private sectors. Means with the cooperation of private industries and government industries, both are setting the rules of the International Telecommunications Union. This telecommunication standardizes sectors, means is to ensure an efficient and one-time production to high-quality standards covering all file of telecommunications. And the next technology is the W3C, means Worldwide Web Consortium. It develops interoperable technologies, specifications, guidelines, softwares, and tools to lead the web to its full potential. By promoting interoperability and encouraging an open forum, the discussion of WC3 committee to leading the technical evaluation of the web, technical evaluation of the World Wide Web. And the next standardization is a global innovative of 3GPP. 3GPP means Third Generation Partnership Project. The 3GPP is to produce globally applicable technical specifications and technical reports and third generation mobile systems. The scope and subsequently amended to include the maintenance and development of global system for mobile communication, that is GSM technical specifications and technical reports. Generating the reports including evolved radio access technologies, means like universal terrestrial radio access, both frequency division and frequency division multiplex and the time division multiplex. The scope was subsequently include specifications and technical reports including evaluated in the access technologies. And the next one is the ANSI, that is American National Standards Institute. American National Standard Institute is the national standard organization in the United States. Okay, it is one of the national standard organization in the United States. In many instances, the US standards are taken forward to ISO and International Electrotechnical Commissions, where they are adapted in the whole as part of the international standards. So NI, so this American National Standards Institute plays an important part in the creating of international standards that supports the worldwide sales of the products. Okay, which prevent the regions from using local standards to favor local industries. And the next one is the UMTS. Is the UMTS full for universal mobile telecommunication systems? Universal mobile communication systems. It represents an evaluation in terms of services and data spends from today's second generation mobile networks like GSM. As a key member of the global family of third generation mobile technologies identified by the International Telecommunications in the evaluation choice for operators of GSM networks. So this universal mobile telecommunication synonyms with a choice of radio access technology that has already been selected by many licensed worldwide. So this UTMS represents an evolution in terms of services and speeds from today's second generation mobile networks in GSM, in GSM technology. Bluetooth. As you all of you know that the Bluetooth standards means Bluetooth is a, first of all, wireless technology. Okay, it is the worldwide specification for a small form factories, low cost radio solutions. That means it provides the links between the mobile computers and the mobile phones. We can connect anywhere in this Bluetooth to mobile computers and mobile phones and other portable handheld devices and connectivity to the internet also. So the standards and specifications for Bluetooth and developed, published and promoted by the Bluetooth Special Internet Group. And the next one is the IMT 2000, International Mobile Telecommunications 2000. It is an ITU standards 3G wireless communication. It provides a framework for worldwide wireless access linking diverse and satellite networks. And the next one is the CDG, CDMA Development Group. I already told you CDMA means Fourth Division Multiple Access. In Reliance Mobiles, they are using the CDMA SIMs in the olden days. The Code Division Multiple Access Group is an international consortium of companies who have joined together to the lead adoption and evaluation of CDMA wireless system around the world. So by working together, the core division members will help ensure interoperability and among the systems with expediting the availability of the CDMA technology consumers. And the next one is the PAM forum. PAM means the Presence and Availability Management Forum. It is the world of computing, knowing the position and context of device is very important. the presence and availability management forum is an independent with a global to accelerate the commercial deployment of the targeted presence and availability of the applications. So the SPAM forum defines a framework for the various threats and specifications needed for the location aware applications. And the next one is the Parley Group. The Parley Group is a multi-vendor consortium formed to develop open technology independent application programming interfaces. So this Parley integrates intelligent network services with IT applications via secure, measured, and billable interface. Parley will also help to develop the location or context-aware applications and services in the worldwide. Next one is the IETF Internet Engineering Task Force. This standard make body for internet and related technologies. This Internet Engineering Task Force is an open international community of network designers, operators, vendors, and research concerned with the evolution of the internet architecture and the smooth operation of the internet. And the next one is the DECT standard. DECT means digital enhanced cordless communications. Digital enhanced cordless communications. It is an ITSS standard for portable phones. Okay, DECT is also known as ITU and as 3G system and is commonly referred to as IMTF frequency time. And the next one is the Wi-Fi Max Forum, worldwide interoperability for microwave access. WiMAX is a forum is dedicated to certifying the operations interconnecting products. So the main aim of the WiMAX is to provide wireless data over long distance different forums, ranging from point to point links to full scale mobile access networks. And the next one, TTA, is the Telecommunications Technology Association. TTA stands for Telecommunication Technology Association. It is the IT standards organization catering to development of new standards based on Corio. So it provides one-stop services for comprehensive IT standards. And the next one is the Wi-Fi Alliance. All of you know that the Wi-Fi standards means Wi-Fi owns trademark of the Wi-Fi. It is previously known as Wireless Ethernet Compatibility Alliance. So it is mainly focused on the interoperability and compatibility of wireless LAN devices. And it is committed to continuous improvements in the design and better user experience. And the next one is the ARIB, Association of Radio Industries and Business. So it is an institution based in Japan, dedicated to efficient user of radio spectrum and its implications in business. So China Communications Standards Association is an attempt of Chinese Ministry of IT to reform telecommunication industry and the market. It aims to become a nationally unified standards organization in China. And the next one is the CCSA, China Communication Standards Association. It is an attempt of Chinese Ministry of IT to adopt to the requirements of telecommunications industry and the market. It aims to for bringing a national unified standards organization in China. And the next one is DLNA, Digital Living and Network Association. It is cross industry association of consumer electronics, computing industry and mobile device companies. The objective of Digital Living Network Association is to enable a seamless environment for sharing digital multimedia context across heterogeneous devices and networks. What are the different players in the wireless space? The stakeholders in the wireless network are regulatory authorities, operator or service providers, subscribers, equipment vendors, research organizations. These are all the different players in the wireless space. So the frequency spectrums are regulated, unregulated. Means the license is required to use regulated spectrums, cordless telephones, microwave ovens, and the use unregulated spectrums. GSM, CDMA use regulated brands. So the journey from cellular network establishment and subscriber activation, network operators conduct survey of the region with a plan for the cell sites. The cell sites gives the design of the architecture of the network. Location of the AP creates the infrastructure. Few manufacturers supplies equipment to the network operators. Like the Nokia phones, Motorola phones, Samsung phones. So every device contains the SIM. SIM is subscriber identity member. Means the SIM contains memory of 8 KB to 64 KB independent processor. So secure data related to network subscriber, SIM supplies or GEM plus, Splumber, Orga, etc. So the user registrations may be prepaid or postpaid subscribers. Some of them are prepaid subscribers are there and some of them are postpaid subscribers are there. So the activation is done within the network and authentication is completed. So certain networks like CDMA, wireless internet loop does not need SIM. So these are all the different standards, different standards followed by the cellular mobile network communications. This is the first chapter. Next, we will discuss the second chapter. 2 minutes, please be on the hold. I will upload the presentation. So we are entering into the chapter 2. See here, chapter 2 is there. So as part of that history of computers, so these are the history of computers. Means in 1943, the British development a computer called cryptanalysis to decode encrypted message transferred by the network. And in the next year, 1944, Aiken developed the automatic sequence controlled calculator mark. And the third next one is the electronic numerical integrator. And in 1945, John Neumann introduced the concept program. And in the, this is the history of the computers too. In 1947, they are invented the transistor by Shockley at Bell Labs, changed the development scenario of digital computers. So by the 1980s, very large scale integration, VLSI, hundreds of thousands of components onto the chip that developed of third generation computers. So all these early computers contained all the components today in your modern day computers, like printers, persistence, memory, operating systems, and stored programs. How aspects of modern day computers were missing in this machines networking aspect of today's computers. And the next, coming to the history of the internet. So the successful launch of Sputnik in 1957 by the Russians, USA felt the need of research in certain focused areas. So the Advanced Research Project Agency was to fund science and technology projects and positions. And how they are invented in 1971, 1972, 1986. Like this, the improvement is there. And the next history of the internet is in October 24, 1995, the FNC unanimously passed a resolution of the officially defined the term internet. According to this resolution, the definition of internet is, internet refers to the global information system. So it is logically linked to together by a global unique address based on the internet protocol on its subsequent access based on us. And during 1960s, the Engelbert prototyped an online services that does hypertext browsing, editing, etc. He involved in for this purpose. So early invented hypertext markup language, that is HTML language. So this hypertext transportation protocol we can use to design as the HTML language. The client program and named it as World Wide Web, which become the WWW and become synonymous with internet. So the two ambiguities networks, the telecommunication network and the internet, different networks have been joined together on uncommon protocol. So GLU for telecommunication network. So the backbone of network and looks at the traffic from the stream of the basic bits point of view. So innermost part of the network function is to deliver traffic. Essential part of deals with transmission media and transfer points. And the next one is the edge, also responsible for the distribution of and looks at the traffic from the service point of generally managed and ISPs for local service exchanges. So the access deals with the last mile of transmission and is either through a wireless or wired networks. So this is the architecture of mobile computing. Please draw the architecture. The three-tier architecture contains the user interface, presentation tier and the process management, the application tier and the data management tier. So I will give 5 minutes time. Please draw the mobile computing architecture. So this is the mobile three-tier architecture. It contains the first user interface, okay, and the next one is the access network. So this user interface is also called as presentation tier, and the next one is the access network. And the third one is the application tier. And fourth one is the data tier. Means there is the communication from user interface. So there is a communication from user interface to application middleware. So it can give the access to user interface to application middleware, and the application middleware can interact with the middleware, which is the process management and business talks. So these are these two can communicate with the database management middleware. The last one is the data. Data storage. So the first one is the user interface level, and the second one is the access network, and the third one is the middle type, and the fourth one is the data table, data type, and last one is the data access. So here he can give in the three tier architecture explanation. In the three tier, user tier deals with the user facing device handling, okay, and it gives the and it concludes includes the user system interface where user services are reside. So the process management or application type, business logic and business logic and access are executed capable of completing hundreds of usages of controls transactions. Third one is the data management or data tier. It is for database access purpose. It provides increased performance, flexibility, maintainability, reusability and scalability while transforming complexity of distributed processing form from a user. So this is the complete architecture of mobile computing. Please note down the figure. And please let me know after your completion of drawing.
మా డ్రా చేసుకోమంటే ఇంకా చిన్నపిల్లలాగా ఫైనల్ ఇయర్కి వచ్చి పిచ్చిగతలు గీయడం కాదు. So the presentation tier, what things are happening, and in the application tier, what are the things are happening, and the data tier, what are the things are happening. Here they are given the detailed explanation. In presentation tier, Internet Explorer, Google Chrome, means the end user can use the all these services. Means touch based browsers, web browser, voice. Next operation and operationable mobile, these are all the presentation layer. So these are communicating with another layers, like iPlant web browser or Java server pages or Apache or HTML or WML HDLL, DoNet tier, JavaScript, internet information service, active server pages, and as in the part of application tier, IBM WebSphere, WebLogic, JBoss, iPlanet, servlets, SAP servlets, enterprise Java Beans. Okay, next PHP, Pike, MS Exchange, MS Conference Service, and as in the part of data tier, XML storage, other application and web browsers, data and as the data and as the files contains. Here they can give the explanation part of presentation tier. So it is responsible for presenting the information to the end user. End user ante evaru manamu evaraithe users andaru manamu suppose manaku ad information kavalan ankonde Google lo manam search chestu untam kada whatever the information we want and whatever the sites we want to browse, we can browse in the Google. So we are opening different windows and we can search for something, right? So ikkada kuda adhe cheptunadu. So end user ane vaallu evaraithe unnaro ante maname end users ante. So end users responsible for presenting the information to the end users. End users ki information nu send chese responsibility anedi presentation layer ku untad anamata. So run on the client device and the offer all the user interfaces includes web browsers and the client programs. So it needs to be context aware and device independent. The software in the client devices in an internal browsers. So the agent software is an applet running on a browser or a machine. So some of these agents who has web scraper in a web scripting embedded functionality of HTTP browser and function automatical browsers. So it picks up part of the data from the web browser and of the remaining data according to some predefined templates applications. Okay, like applications are like B2B, B2C,
B2C, B2E, M2M, like that. And here I explain about the application type. So the application tier, independent of presentation and database management systems, it handles special functions related to middleware, and it performs business logic of processing user input and observing data and making decisions in network management and space management and super disaster. So the middleware layer of software sitting between the operating system and the user facing software. So many types of middlewares are there: message oriented middleware, transaction processing middleware, database middleware, communication middleware, distributed objects middleware, components middleware, transcoding middleware. Like that, we have different types of middlewares are available in the market. Okay, so we can choose any one of the middleware while communicating the specific systems. Okay, so middleware software sitting between the operating system and the user facing software system. So and the next one is the message oriented middleware. So loosely connects different applications through asynchronous exchange of messages. So works independent of platform or processor configurations, generally asynchronous and as peer to peer. So the message contains formatted data, represents for acting unsolicited response. It provides a message queue between two interopening applications. So if destination is out of service, so busy, and the message is held temporary storage location until proceed.